Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So in my previous video I have shown you how SMTP sampler works. So whenever we get something or the other to test, we test that particular entity, and after the test completion we used to send a report. So in my previous video I have integrated both the section, both the actions, so the testing as well as sending an email. So with the help of SMTP sampler I have done that. So in order to execute that test, what we'll have to do, we have to open our JMeter tool. Once the JMeter tool has been initiated, okay, so once this is initiated we have to look for that particular script. So this is my script, and after that I have to run this particular script. So this is what I'll have to do every time whenever I'll get something whenever I'll get something to test. So every time I'll have to do some manual effort. So in this video I'll explain you how we can reduce this manual effort and we can execute our test with the help of a batch file. So let me show you how it works and then I'll explain you I have a sanity underscore JMeter, a bat file. Once I double click this bat file, it starts a test. So starting the sanity test using JMeter. So and this is running a test which is located at this location. So in F drive I have a JMX file name as smtpsampler.jmx. So in this JMX file, after testing, once the testing is done, I'll receive an email, and that email will also contain the log files of the test execution if something or the other fails or pass. So I will receive an email in my mail ID named as modirakesh03.qa once the test is completed. Yet I have not received any email. So here also you can see the test is running. So it takes sometimes, as in backend it initialize the JMeter tool, select for the particular scripts, it's run the scripts, and then we'll get the result. Yes, it has run the script and there is zero error. So yes, it's still running the test. Okay, let me check if I received an email. Okay, I have not yet received an email. Once the test will be completed I will receive an email. So better to wait for the test completion. Okay, so here you can see in a summary it took 14 samples which took 55 seconds and then it completed the test execution. Yes, here you can see the test has ended with a 0% error. Okay, so let me check whether I have received an email or not. Yes, I could not see any email here. Yes, now you can see I have an email at 11:10:58. Right now I have received an email once the test has been completed. So this is how I'll receive an email once the test completed. So here in this particular video I have demonstrated you how we can reduce the manual effort. Instead of initializing the tool, selecting for a particular script and executing it manually, we can run it with the help of a batch file just by double clicking it. Okay, so now let me show you what is there in a batch file. So just go to this particular batch file, edit with a notepad. So yes, this is how one can also create its batch file. So I have created a batch file in my desktop. So first of all I have to go to my F drive where my JMeter lies. So in the JMeter I have gone to my bin directory, and once I have been into my bin directory I have just written the JMeter command for executing the script in a non-GUI mode. So this is the command for executing a JMeter in a non-GUI mode, and after that I have also given a comment that test completed. So this is how we can design a bat file with the help of which we can reduce the human effort, the manual test effort for executing the test. So this is what I wanted to explain in this video. So if anyone has any doubt, can please comment in the below section of the video, as well as you can like and subscribe my video. Thank you everyone for watching.